Any change that we want to make needs to take the environment into account. But why should we do this? The principle of sustainable development is the key here. Anything that we do today should not compromise future generations. From a local perspective, sustainable development is included in NEMA and requires that social, economic, and environmental factors are taken into account when planning for man-made changes to the environment. To ensure that any changes we make to our environment are in the best interests of all, environmental assessments of these activities are required. These assessments allow for all the facts to be laid out before decisions are made. These assessments are important to ensure that there are no substantially detrimental impacts on the environment, to allow for the public to be involved in decision-making that could affect them and their environments, and to regulate processes such that the authorities can make informed decisions on whether to allow these processes to continue or not. From these environmental assessments, the relevant authorities are able to determine if authorization should be given. The assessments also provide a plan on how the activities, which could have a negative impact on the environment, will be managed to protect both the environment but also nearby residents. Environmental assessments have many advantages. These include helping authorities to make decisions and improve the management of resources, as well as to understand the bigger picture in the area. To the interested and affected parties, it is an opportunity to be heard, while for the applicant, it is a way of determining the appropriateness of the activity in the area. In South Africa, there are essentially two types of environmental assessments: basic assessments and environmental impact assessments. The National Environmental Management Act also requires that an environmental management plan forms part of these submissions. Enforcement of these regulations has also become more strict with additional law enforcement officers and the Green Scorpions. Basic assessments are required for activities that are laid out in Listing Notice 1. These are typically smaller activities where the impact is generally known and which can be easily managed. When a more thorough assessment is needed, an EIA is performed. This is typically when more complex activities are undertaken that may have higher levels of pollution, waste, environmental degradation, or are considered higher risk activities. Unfortunately, environmental assessments may take a long time. The authority will have a set time to respond to submissions, but should there be any queries needing a response, the clock is reset at day zero each time there is a resubmission. While environmental assessments are ways to investigate potential activities on site, there is also a need to have a plan put together on what would happen should negative environmental impacts occur. This is where the environmental management plan needs to come in to show how these environmental impacts would be managed.